Hello friends, this is Dr. S.M. Khan, Associate Professor, Department of Psychology, Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh. Now, I am talking about the relationship of phi coefficient with contingency coefficient. Both coefficients are from the family of non-parametric statistical methods. Phi coefficient is a measure of association between two binary natural dichotomous variables. For example, living dead, black, white, success, failure, etc. At least one variable is a nominal variable. The phi coefficient is a symmetrical statistic, which means the independent variable and dependent variables are interchangeable. So there is no independent or dependent variable in your research problem. This is a measure of association based on adjusting chi-square significance to factor out sample size. The range of phi is between minus 1 and 1 for 2 by 2 tables, but will be difficult for larger tables. The phi coefficient is often used as a measure of association in 2 by 2 tables formed by true dichotomies. Computationally, phi is the square root of chi square divided by n, and n is the sample size. Phi coefficient can be checked with Pearson R obtained from the same table. Phi coefficient is useful in item analysis to determine item to item correlation. Phi coefficient makes no assumption regarding the form of distribution. So it is a distribution free test. The relation with the contingency coefficient is chi square is equal to n into phi square. When any doubt about exact nature of dichotomy, then it is suggested to calculate phi coefficient. The contingency coefficient is an adjustment to phi coefficient, intended to adapt it to tables larger than 2 by 2. The contingency coefficient is a coefficient of association that tells whether two variables or data sets are not related or related to each other. The contingency coefficient is computed as the square root of chi square divided by chi square plus n, and n is the sample size. A contingency coefficient is particularly informative if you are working with a large sample and you don't need to find out if an association is complete or not, just whether or not the association exists. The contingency coefficient will be always less than 1 and will be approaching 1 only for large tables. The larger the contingency coefficient, the stronger the association. Pearson's C is more appropriate for larger tables, 4x4, etc. Why? Because its upper limit depends on the number of rows and columns. Upper limit can be calculated using the formula square root of k minus 1 divided by k, where k is number of rows and columns. Some researchers recommend it only for 5x5 tables or larger. For smaller tables, it will underestimate the level of association. If you compare the formula that we are in a position to make the comparison, we have studied in earlier discussions or videos about the phi coefficient and contingency coefficient. The phi, the formula BC minus AD divided by EFGH, and contingency coefficient, you can use two either of formula. One has a direct bearing with the chi-square, and another is also having in the background the similar statistics, chi-square. Thank you.